Some people feel that they don't need security software while in public Wi-Fi because they don't access unsafe websites anyway. But what are unsafe websites? Are these the websites that we end up visiting because there was an email that arrived or an instant messaging that arrived and we clicked the link and we ended up in the website? And this is now trying to steal our credentials or deliver malware? And yes, these are the clear-cut malicious websites that are out to get us. But what about that favorite news website that you visit every day? Is that a safe website? What if last night it was hacked and it has been exploited and now it hosts this tiny bit of malicious code that when the visitor visits the website, the visitor could get redirected to another website, which is now hosting malware? Or what if your news website is subscribed to an advertising platform, and due to the dynamic nature of these ads, now the news website has pulled an advertisement that is malicious? The truth about these websites is that the moment that a website owner puts a tiny bit of his code out there and hosts the website, traffic comes. And unfortunately, this is not the type of traffic that every new website owner craves. This is the type of traffic that probes the website for vulnerabilities. And when the attacker gets into the website, then this is the moment that this website becomes dangerous for the visitors. So whether you are in the comforts of your home, in a corporate environment, or in public Wi-Fi, you cannot really ascertain in advance that the website that you are visiting today is as safe as it was yesterday. So instead of worrying about it, you leave the worry to your security software.